Echo.
Welcome to the final episode of the year of Birmingham Goes Live. I'm Suna.
And I'm Alice Key. And on today's show, we'll be joined by one of the community wardens in Selly Oak. We'll also be having a look back at the elections from previous weeks. And also, we'll be chatting to two of the members of the Improv Society.
We'll also be having our weekly update from Guild TV's very own Dave Veneer, as well as the thought for the day from Drinks to Go, the Drinks to Go man, who is the legend of Selly Oak.
I'm really looking forward to that later. So much knowledge they've given us in the past couple of weeks. Right, but first we're going to have a look at the rehearsals for the new musical, not musical, sorry, for the new play, Jerusalem.
I'm Nicole, I'm co-director of Jerusalem.
Hi, I'm Alicia and I'm also co-director of Jerusalem.
Been in Amsterdam last year and my friend said, I've just read this play, it's great, you should read it. So I read it and I was in a cafe using their free Wi-Fi and stuff, and I ended up getting chucked out because I didn't even buy anything. I got so stuck into this play and I couldn't leave before I finished it. Mm-hmm. And it was excellent, and because I missed the West End showing, I was kind of like, I really want to put it on so I can see it.
I saw Jerusalem in the West End when I was doing A-level drama, and it was just the most incredible thing. It was funny and it was moving and there was music and it was just amazing. And so this term, basically, I have an incredible amount of work I'm supposed to be doing, so I said I'm not doing a single play, I'm not doing any plays in term two unless it's Jerusalem. It's one of my absolute favourite plays, but it's really difficult to describe the plot.
So it's St George's Day. It's all set in one day on St George's Day, and the kind of local menace who lives in a caravan in a clearing is having a big party because he's just been told he's going to be evicted by the council, and he deals drugs. I say he's a menace. It's a bit ambiguous because he's also kind of this fatherly figure to lots of local kids that are a bit displaced. So that's the central kind of action.
For this play, it's more of a laugh for me, really. My last play was a bit of a horror.
It's a massive cast and a massive production team, and when I heard that they were putting Jerusalem on, I was like, wow, that is a task, because it's so set heavy and accents and loads of characters. So I think it's different in that it's ambitious, but we're pulling it off.
It's really nice having such a big cast. I think lots of shows, particularly in the Guild, because it's easier to rehearse, have smaller casts. But this is quite big. And because we've not all been in scenes together, we don't often meet at rehearsals. So when we do have big group rehearsals like today, it's a lot of fun.
We play hard.
Yes, we do.
So pleased with who we got.
Honestly, we couldn't have found a better cast.
There were characters that we thought would really struggle with finding someone, and we were just so lucky because we just found the perfect person for each role.
My character's such an awful person, as I say, and it's nice to be able to play that because you say stuff and you act in certain ways that you just wouldn't in real life, because you'd get locked up. So it's nice to kind of have that freedom to do. To be a really awful person, but in a nice way.
Because it's absolutely hilarious. I've got a favourite line that I say, which is hilarious, a favourite line that someone says to me, which is hilarious, a favourite line that someone says about me, which is hilarious, a favourite line which has nothing to do with me. It's just so funny. The play is so funny, but it's also a really good drama with a really good story and interesting characters and everything you want from a good play.
Also, it swings very quickly from comedy to darker themes, and I think that's something that I haven't experienced being in plays or anything. So
it's being performed on Wednesday the 19th of March, Thursday the 20th of March, and Friday the 21st of March. However, Friday is sold out, which just shows how good it is, really. Yep.
Maybe the dates are on the back of the jumper.
Yeah.
Are they?
Are they
on the back of the jumper?
Yeah, they are.
Yeah. Those dates. Mm-mm.
I do not represent the views of Article 19 or any of the production crew or cast. I am just one idiot.
I just did that, sorry.
Our first guest in the studio today is Alex Seftel from the I Love Selly Oak Community Warden Scheme. It's a pleasure to have you on the show today.
Thank you very much for GILTV for inviting me on.
And first of all, what does the Community Warden Scheme offer to students and what's your role within the scheme?
Okay, so I'm one of a team of 8 community wardens. Essentially, we're a team of students driven to make the Selly Oak area safer, cleaner, greener, and just generally a nicer place to live. We also work alongside the West Midlands Police, the Fire Service, and the Council. And so in doing that, we become kind of an intermediary body between those services and obviously the Guild, students and residents who aren't students that live in Selly Oak. So it's a great piece of community work.
So obviously at the moment, students might be a little bit worried about their safety in Selly Oak. So what advice would you give to students to stay safe?
Absolutely. Well, I'm keen to stress there have been a couple of isolated incidents recently, but all it needs really is for students to be more aware and vigilant of what's around them. A lot of incidents tend to happen when students have just left their doors open or the windows open. So the advice is obviously is as soon as you get in the house is to secure the door. Or if you're going out, obviously secure windows as well, because you might not think it, but a very small window can be entered by an intruder. In terms of personal safety, there's a great thing called Immobilise. It's a scheme run by the police where you can register your personal items, and if they are lost or stolen, you have a much higher chance of tracing them. But I'm also keen to stress the police are very good at what they do, and they do respond accordingly very well, and you only have to follow them on social media. At West Midlands Police is their Twitter, to know that they do some great work.
Great. Tell us a bit about the patrols that you do around the Selly Oak area.
Sure, well, the patrols are great fun. We go up and down the streets of Selly Oak every week and we look out for things. You may have seen mattresses and fridges and wardrobes and all sorts on the streets. And what we do is we report them, we note them down, we send that off to the council, and then when the council are doing their collections, they know where the problems are and they can sort it out and make the area a bit cleaner, a bit nicer to live in, rather than having a mattress outside your front door. I had a fridge outside my front door recently. I thought maybe people just didn't have time for breakfast in the morning, but it's now been removed. We also look out for insecure doors and windows which might compromise students' security, and we advise them accordingly.
So you work quite closely with the police. So what sort of schemes do you work with them on, and how do you communicate with them?
Well, that's right. We have, first of all, the police regularly do something called an All Out Their Day, which is they have a stall by Grange Road Gates, that part of campus. And that's there to give advice to students, as well as to give away things like door alarms, window lights that are there designed to improve the students' security. And then later on, that turns into a night patrol where we meet with the police and have a little brief and find out that some of the latest information. We're able to advise students just generally give them some advice and to reassure them, but also to look out for anything suspicious.
What would you say is the most enjoyable experience you've had in your time as community warden?
Well, it's a difficult one because there's a lot of highlights. We have a lot of banter as a team. We've been involved with St Mary's Hospice, Tiverton School, but the most enjoyable piece of work was last week. And we were collecting empty alcohol bottles from first year flats in exchange for chocolate. And from one flat in Elgar, we managed to retrieve nearly 400 bottles. It was an hour of back-breaking work, but it was worth it in the end. Good fun.
So you're obviously very passionate about the work that you do. How would you encourage other students to get involved with the community wardens?
Yeah, I certainly would, not least because, and it sounds a bit sensationalist in a way, but I kind of feel empowered to make change to people on a daily basis. I mean, the awareness of the scheme isn't the best, and that's one reason why I'm on GILTV today. But the change that we're able to make to people, whether they come to us with problems or we spot the problem on a patrol, we're actually able to solve that problem and therefore brighten someone's day.
Thanks a lot for coming on the show, Alex.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to Alex there from the Community Wardens. Now we're going to have a quick look back at the last week and a half of elections. You might have seen that Guild Television did quite a lot of coverage of the elections process, as well as Burn FM and Redbrick as well. But we're going to have a look back at some of the footage that we got from there.
we're joined on the show by James and Ollie from Baron Sternlook's Big Naughty Improv Musical. Hi guys.
Hello to you. You right?
If you could just introduce yourselves and tell us a bit more about your company really and what it offers.
Okay, my name's James Lovelock and we are Baron Sternlook's Big Naughty Improvised Musical. This is Oliver Friston, who's one of our cast members. And we basically do what we say there. We make up musicals on the spot based on a suggestion from the audience.
Yeah, so I'm as part of the cast, there's a cast of about sort of, I don't know, between, it varies sort of depending on who's available on what days, but because it's made up on the spot, it doesn't matter how many people we have, we will take a suggestion from the audience of a song title or a title of a musical, and we have to make up the whole thing, sort of a full musical with songs and a good storyline, just based on that suggestion sort of on the spot.
So I'm going to apologise because earlier I called you guys a society. You're not a society, you're actually a group. But you've got a very original name, so let us know where that name came from.
It's all from me, I'm afraid, which is a little bit sort of egotistical. But when I was, I used to be a teacher, and when I was training, people used to think, well, how on earth do you control a class? How do you control a class? You. And I said, well, you say, well, it's all in the nose, it's in the stern look you see there.
When you're oh, I like that, it's clever.
And so I became known as Mr. Sternlook, and I thought I'd promote myself because misters aren't very important, really. Yeah. And I thought, I've got a baronly look about me. So I became Baron Sternlook when we set up the improvised musical, so that's sort of where the name comes from.
And how do you go about improvising? Is there a kind of a magic formula, a magic technique that you have in rehearsals?
Oh, it's like I said, it's different every time because you do it based on completely suggestions and you never know what's going to come out of the hat or the pitcher or jug or whatever we're using at that sort of to put the suggestions in. But at the same time, it's you can't just do it sort of without practicing. You can become sort of better at improvising through rehearsing. Like if you know things about how a good song structure works, how a good musical structure works with a good start, middle and end, and how you sort of get it all to work like that. And it's really helpful rehearsing with the group of people, because if you know kind of who you're working with, you know what everyone's skills are, you know that we have Florence, who is really good at sort of leading storylines, we have Alice, who's really good at sort of like coming up with a really good character, and you know sort of what works and what doesn't work in the group, and that's sort of going to help you make it better.
I mean, I think the key thing is that anyone can improvise, because improvising is basically what you just do in life. You know, every day when you get up, you improvise. And so what I wanted to set this company up for really was to allow anybody to have a go. We're an unauditioned company. The cast just happened to decide they fancied having a go at it, and they've stuck with it, and that's how we've got a show, really. So that's important to me, that the musical is open to anybody that wants to be part of it.
So tell us more about the show and the events that you guys have got coming up.
Well, on Monday, we're back at the Lounge on Bristol Road in Selly Oak at 8 o'clock, and we're doing Baron Sternlook's Big Naughty Improvised Musical, a full-length musical there. And then, excitingly, I'm very excited about this, we're going up to Edinburgh for the Fringe Festival. So wow. Exciting. And we're up there for the whole month, from the 31st of July to the 25th of August. We're playing at Spotlights at Merchants Hall, and we're doing a show every day for a month, and it's going to be great.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to doing it every day for a month, because at the moment we're doing a show every sort of, we're trying to rehearse sort of once every week, a show every couple of weeks, but actually doing a show every day for a month is going to develop us so much, like, as a cast. And I've never done Edinburgh Fringe before. It's something I've always wanted to do, and like, I'm really looking forward to it.
You're going to be performing later on in the show, and you've given us permission to come up with the name of the song that you're going to be performing, isn't that right?
That's right, yes, we're looking forward to it. Yes, we don't want to know what the title is first. People tend to think that when we improvise we have sort of some sort of something already arranged, but we don't know what this is going to be, and I'm really looking forward to it.
There's nothing arranged.
No, like, I'm really looking forward completely... to it. What silliness does happen?
If it's really, really, if it is really bad, which it shouldn't be, but apologies in advance.
I can't believe you guys trusted us with allowing you to do it, to be honest, so thanks very much for that.
No problem.
Right, so we're going to play a game with you first, guys. Ooh, I think we're going to play a game of Taboo. So, Suna, you can grab our beautiful board there for us. Brilliant, look at that, guys, lovely. So much budget goes on that. So the way that Taboo works is you get a minute. We're going to give you a list of words, and they're going to be related to our theme. So our theme today is crime, obviously going with our community warden interview we had earlier. So I'm going to give one of you the list, and there's a load of words that you can't say.
Okay.
So you've got to describe the word, but there are certain things you can't say. So which one of you is going to be doing talking, which one is going to be doing the guessing?
You do the talking, I do the guessing.
So I'm going to give you this one. Don't show him.
I'm not going to show
him. Keep that secret. Deadly secret.
And just a quick look, the score to beat is 10 points. That's from Poppy Wilkinson and Ed Sainsbury. So that's 6 seconds for the question. No pressure, guys.
Improvising games, come on.
Right, so I'm going to be checking that you're adhering to the rules.
Yes.
And you're going to be timing, aren't you?
Yep.
So whenever you guys are ready, I'm going to count down from 5.
Nino, sorry, I've
got it. Yet.
Oh, I was keen.
Right, are we ready, Suna?
We are ready.
Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Nino, big help.
Police, ambulance, sirens.
This person might have done it, but they might not have done.
Suspect?
I'm going to ask you lots and lots of things.
Witness, interrogation.
I've taken this away from you. Ha-ha.
Stealing. Burglary.
The person that does that.
Burglar.
But close to that.
Robber, thief.
Yes. You've been terribly naughty and you're causing naughtiness. I'm going to come and go shh with this.
Under arrest,
with this thing. I sometimes have it with salt on my dinner.
Oh, shaker, cellar.
No, I had the other thing with salt and...
Pepper.
But I...
Pepper spray.
But you might need this if you're like me and you're not very good at when somebody attacks you. You might want
pepper
to go
spray?
To one of these.
No, rape alarm.
No, you might want to go to one of these
community
wardens? Teaching things. It teaches me how
self-defense class.
Yes. I might hit you with this if I want to steal something.
Like baseball bat.
Oh,
it was
guys.
Weapon. It was weapon.
Well, you did pretty well there. No, like apart from the fact that was really entertaining.
What did we get?
Well, you got 6.
That's not bad.
It's not
6.
Bad, to be fair. Bad. It was very entertaining anyway.
And we're not presidents, so that's probably why. Yes.
Lord.
No,
magistrate.
These are the ones we haven't done, is there?
Well, you can always come back, I'm sure, if the show returns next season and try your luck again at
we
that
might
one.
Do that.
We're being pinned on
right,
the board.
You're going on the board.
Beautiful photos.
Beautiful photos on the board.
Oh, I love it. Well, thank you so much, guys, for joining us on the show.
Thanks for having us. It's been fun.
I really look forward to your little improv a little bit later on in the show. Thank you.
Thanks very much.
Thanks. What are we doing next, Suna?
So next, we're going to be looking at a quick VT from the Drinks to Go Man, or as he's known in Selly Oak, the Lolly for the Lady Man.
Drinks to Go Man's thought for the day.
If you're an animal, what would you be?
A dog.
Drinks to Go Man's thought for the day.
Thank you very much there to the Drinks to Go Man. Really insightful thought there, Suna. Right, so next we're going to go and have a look at what Dave's been going up to this week. Now it's his last weekly update for Guild Television. So let's go and see what events are happening around the Guild.
The rest is all in, dissertation nearly done, and second term's nearly over. There's only one more question to ask. What the Guild TV is going on this week?
Where better to start than tonight, other than here in the underground in the Guild, where Article 19 are putting on Jerusalem. Not only my favourite school hymn, but also a great play about Johnny Rooster Byron, Lord of Misrule, a wanted man and general waster. It's on here for 3 nights only, so make sure you are one of the lucky ones who gets a ticket.
That show sounds great, but you're more in the mood for a dance show. Well, you're in luck because the University Dance Society are putting on their annual amazing dance show, and this year the theme is the world stage. So get ready to see dance from America to Antarctica, Budapest to Belarus, Cardiff to Croydon. It's on for 3 nights and tickets are available on the Guild website, so grab your card and get clicking.
Why watch dancing when you can hit the dance for yourself? Tomorrow night, the Wanted are playing in the LG Arena, and they're supported by the Vamp. So get on down. I know what I want, a ticket. Cheesy pop and boy band quips aren't your thing, but student stand-up comedy is? Well, get ready to be excited, because the Footnotes Comedy Society are putting on their regular stand-up event. And it's tomorrow night at 7:30 in the Bristol Pear. So go along and get your sides split. It's time to play the music. It's time to light the lights. It's time to meet the Muppets as they start in their new film, Muppets Most Wanted. The film not only stars your favourite Muppets, but also stars Ty Burrell, Ricky Gervais and Tom Hiddleston. As the Muppets travel all over Europe, I wonder why they didn't come to Birmingham. On Monday, get yourself to dance here at the House of America, a play that looks at a family in the 80s in the valleys of Wales. The play uses traditional Welsh music and new rock and roll to produce something truly original.
prefer your plays totally unscripted, well, you're in luck because Baron Sternlicht is doing another improvised musical this Monday in the lounge at 7:30. And tickets are only £3, so make sure you go along. Well, this has been my last weekly update. It's been a pleasure telling you what's been going on here in Birmingham. I've been Adele Bazim. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you very much, Dave, there for his weekly update. We've really enjoyed all the weekly updates from the show for the last couple of weeks. So thank you very much, Dave, and good luck in your presenting in the future. Also, thank you very much to all the guests that we featured on today's show. If you want to watch the episode again, then you can on GuildTV's website. But please tune in for next season's Birmingham Goes Live.
And we're now joined by James and Ollie once again for their rendition of an improvised song, Jailhouse Sock. Take it away, guys.
When you're down in the jailhouse, make sure you've got some socks. You won't want your feet getting cold. Down in the jailhouse, watch out for that mouse, he might steal your sock. There can be danger lurking round the corner. There can be a sharp noun or a squirrel or something more. Make sure that your footwear is a suitable attire. Make sure that you don't step on that piece of wire. Jailhouse sock and jailhouse shoes are good for you. Jailhouse sock and jailhouse shoes. Jailhouse sock,
jailhouse sock
and jailhouse shoes are good for you. You want suitable attire.
Suitable attire.
Maybe one day I'll get out of jail, and I won't have to wear the socks. The streets outside are safe for my feet, thanks to the Selly Oak community wardens. Jailhouse sock,
jailhouse sock,
and jailhouse shoes are good for you. Jailhouse sock and jailhouse shoes. Jailhouse sock, oh jailhouse sock, and jailhouse shoes are good for you. Suitable footwear attire.